Data validation rules in Excel are used to control what users can enter into a cell. So this could be something like a number between certain values or only items from an existing list. So for this example, I have a note here that says the value must be a whole number between 1 and 10. So I'll create a data validation rule to limit entries to just these values. So with my cell selected, the data validation rules would be under the Data tab in the Data Tools section, and once here, click on Data Validation. First, we need to select what we'll allow. So in this case, I need a whole number, and I need it between 1 and 10. So my minimum will be 1, my maximum will be 10, and click OK. So when you create a data validation rule, by default, Excel is going to apply a stop alert. So see what happens if I try to type a number that is not within the rule settings. This type of alert prevents the cell from accepting my entry even after I've pressed enter. It also displays a pop-up message that reads, this value doesn't match the data validation restrictions defined for this cell. So the thing is, if you stick to just using the default alert, you're missing a really great opportunity to educate your users on how to fix whatever they entered so that it does match the rule settings. So let's walk through our error alert options. So you can set the alert settings as you're making your rule, or you can edit an existing rule. So in this example, we're editing the rule we created just a moment ago. And because the rule is already set, I'll need to select the cell range that has the rule applied to it. And with those cells selected, we'll need to go back into data validation. And for this, we'll need to go into the error alert tab. So the first thing you'll want to do is make sure that the show error alert after invalid data is entered box is checked off, or your rule won't do anything. So notice if I uncheck this box, how I'm able to enter whatever value I want into these cells, despite that I have a rule set up that's supposed to prevent me from entering anything that is not a whole number between 1 and 10. So let's undo this and go back into data validation, check off our box. So here you have three styles of error alerts to choose from, and each behaves just a little differently. So this stop alert is the default setting. This is the one we saw just a moment ago. It prevents users from typing anything that does not match the settings in the data validation rule. So again, if I was to enter 1.5 into any of these cells, I'm not able to do that and I get the default message. Let's go back into data validation. The next option is a warning. And notice how the icon here changes to a warning symbol. So this alert communicates that an error has been entered in a cell, but it still gives the user the option to ignore the alert and continue with their entry without making a correction. So again, if I type a number outside my parameters, it lets me know that my entry is invalid, but I can still click yes to continue. So let's delete this and we'll select ourselves again and go back into data validation. The next style option is information. This one is the most lenient one and it tells the user that their entry doesn't match the data validation rule settings, but it still lets them continue without fixing it. So for this one, if I type something outside of my settings, it just says this value doesn't match, but I can just click OK and it'll still be accepted. So let's delete this. Obviously, you would choose the alert type that works best for your project and your audience. But regardless of which you choose, this is still a really great opportunity to give your users instructions on how to fix what they entered. So with our cell selected, we'll go back into data validation. Under the error alert tab, So again, make sure that the show error alert after invalid data is entered is checked off, because if it's not, no error message is going to display and your users will be able to enter whatever invalid data. And select which of the three types of error alert warnings you'd like for your project. So I'm going to select stop for this example. And next, create a title for your error alert. So in this example, we could title it something like score values between 1 and 10. Then in the error message field, we can write more detail about the error and instructions for how to fix it. But keep in mind that it's still a good idea to be brief. So for our example, we can write something like values can only be whole numbers between 1 and 10. And then in parentheses, we'll type some whole numbers as examples. And when you're done, click OK. Now, if we type something that's outside of the settings, we'll get this customized data validation error message. So thanks for watching, and for more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.